My name is Stella Chinazor. I am to present attitude of nurses towards professional development for improved service delivery at the Jos University Teaching Hospital, Jos, Nigeria. The content of this presentation will include the article title, which has been said, summary, problem of the study, methods, results and discussions, conclusion, and then the references. Summary. This research work is titled Attitude of Nurses Towards Professional Development for Improved Service Delivery at the Jos University Teaching Hospital. The research paper evaluated the knowledge of nurses about professional development, various methods used in professional development, factors that encourage nurses, and factors that militate against their involvement in professional development. It also assessed the attitude of nurses toward professional development trainings and tried to proffer suggestions that will improve the professional development of nurses. It was a prospective randomized questionnaire-based cross-sectional descriptive survey of the attitude of nurses towards professional development among nurses working at the Jos University Teaching Hospital, Jos, Nigeria. 131 nurses were studied. 99 representing 76% were females and 22 representing 24% were males. Results show that although the majority of the nurses showed adequate knowledge about the nursing profession and nurse and professional development, many factors militated against nurses' interest in the professional development trainings, including family commitments, distances, time, and lack of institutional financial support. It is recommended that professional development trainings are vital tools in achieving personal and organizational goals. Nurses should be motivated and encouraged to participate in the professional development trainings in order to achieve the goal of quality healthcare delivery to our patients. Problem of the study. Continuous life learning. So continuous lifelong learning is a good aim in life. Everybody keeps learning until death. And in nursing, we find out that schools, colleges, and university programs could not provide all the extensive range of learning experiences necessary for graduate nurses to become effective in practice area. The aim of professional development is largely to learn and apply new knowledge and skills that will improve performance on the job through knowledge and skills updates so as to increase productivity. Healthcare professionals have always been encouraged to update their knowledge and maintain clinical competence due to the rapid changes currently taking place within the healthcare systems. Professional development, therefore, is one of the ways these experiences are gained. There is an increase in service training or professional development for nurses in our healthcare institutions, yet patients and relations still complain of the quality of care rendered to them. Senior nurses and other healthcare team also expressed concern on the reduction of the standard of care rendered in our health institutions. Is professional development actually towards the improvement in the quality of healthcare delivery, or are there other reasons why nurses engage in professional development? Furthermore, while there are several studies reporting professional developments in the teaching profession, there appears to be a dearth of studies on professional development relating to nursing profession. This research, therefore, evaluated the attitude of nurses towards professional development for improved service delivery at the Jos University Teaching Hospital, Jos, Nigeria. The framework this work this study is hinged on is Haider's theory of attitudinal change, which was adopted for this study. The theory suggests that three components of attitude, cognitive, affective, and behavior, are and are best, viewed if they are in balance. Heider maintains that for a balance or equilibrium of attitude to take place, the sum of the signs in the three components should be positive. That is the cognitive, the affective, and the behavioral. As nurses engage in all forms of professional development, such as seminars, workshops, mandatory professional trainings, and further schools, etc., the skills and knowledge gained should be put to practice for improved service delivery to the patients. This will be a way of manipulating the working environment, making it conducive, and giving rise to effective effective components of practice. This was a prospective, randomized, cross-sectional descriptive study of the attitude of nurses working in Jos University Teaching Hospital. Data were collected using a pre-validated 4-point structured questionnaire after a pilot study centered on the research variables, research questions, and the objectives. Approval was obtained from the Ethical Committee of the Management of the Hospital, JUS, and informed consent was obtained from the participants before the study was carried out. Data were analyzed for gender, age, knowledge, and attitude, and presented in numerals and proportions in percentage and tables. Results and discussion. There were 131 respondents who consented to participate in the study. 99 were females and 22 were males. The ratio of female to male was 4.5 to 1. 23 were aged 20 to 29 years, 60, 30 to 39 years. 28 of them were aged age range of 40 to 49 years, while 20 were 50 years and above. 54, representing 41% of the respondents studied, have working experience for 11 to 15 years, followed by 32 who have worked for 15 years and above. Less than 5 years were 23, and 6 to 10 years were 22 respectively. Concerning nurses' knowledge about nursing and professional development, majority of nurses in the study across the various cadre have good knowledge of nursing and professional development and believe that the training received at the basic school was not enough to give the required quality care to patients, and that the training can be in various forms. This is in agreement with what Broco and Putman provided evidence to support the fact that professional development programs play an essential role in career development, and it changes methodologies. Professional development is known to improve efficiency, effectiveness, and service delivery, according to Broco and Putman. Thus, institutional priority for professional development for nurses and other healthcare team should be encouraged, as this will improve knowledge and skills for quality healthcare delivery. On the question about the perception of nurses towards professional development for attitudinal change, the evidence in the present study showed that nurses have a positive perception and right attitude about professional development, given the right opportunity, necessary motivation, support, and encouragement. Some of the reasons why nurses undertake professional development included personal interest, quest for further knowledge and skills for quality care delivery, job satisfaction, professionalism, motivation, and sponsorship. About factors that militate against nurses for further professional development, unfortunately, some of the nurses in the study were limited by factors such as distances, the need for government and institutional management to support and encourage the nurses and other healthcare team to encourage, to engage in their efforts in professional development. Results. Factors that encourage nurses for further professional development in the study include personal interest, quest for knowledge, and development of new skills for practice and motivation. Conclusion. Nurses in this study showed adequate knowledge and understanding of the concept of professional development and ways of improving it. They appreciated that professional development is necessary to achieve the individual and organizational goal of quality healthcare delivery to the patients. However, they have need to be motivated, sponsored, encouraged, and to be able to overcome the limiting factors. Nurses were largely in consensus that professional development is a tool. Different professional development courses are offered in